Dear learners, I am Dr. Vinay Supe. Today we will discuss the topic on propagation, planting, training and pruning of pomegranate. Pomegranate is one of the important arid zone fruit crop grown in Maharashtra. Propagation plays a key role in pomegranate cultivation. Pomegranate plants can be raised through seeds as well as vegetative method. There are two types of methods, one is sexual and another is asexual. However, this pomegranate crop, it is being cross-pollinated crop. The plants raised through sexual propagation, that is seeds, shows some variation. That's why vegetative propagation is widely accepted method of propagation in pomegranate. There are various methods of vegetative propagation. These methods are cutting, air layering and tissue culture. That is the recent technique in pomegranate propagation. Now let us discuss the first method, that is cutting method. Pomegranate can be propagated from softwood as well as hardwood cuttings. There are two types of cuttings, softwood and hardwood. By both the types, we can go for propagation of pomegranate. Softwood is green in color and it has age of 6 to 9 months. However, hardwood is brownish in color and it has age of more than 9 months. Hardwood cuttings are mostly preferred for propagation instead of softwood cuttings. Hardwood cuttings gives higher success rate and bear fruit in 2 years after planting. For hardwood cuttings, the rainy season or early winter is the best time for propagation. The time of hardwood cutting, the propagation is in between June to September. We can also get the hardwood cuttings from matured water shoots. Water shoots are the branches which arise from the base of the plant and under the canopy, and they do not fruit up to 1 year, so that they can better utilize for propagation. Now we will see how the hardwood cuttings are prepared. Preparation of hardwood cuttings. Before taking the cuttings, defoliate the branch 8 days prior. This will help to accumulate the carbohydrates inside the stick. Select cutting of about 10 inches length. It should be more than 9 months old. The cutting stick should be of pencil thickness and should have 4 to 6 buds at least. After taking the cuttings should be put in the wet cunny bags for 8 days. Take slanting cut at the basal portion of the cuttings at the time of planting. Dip the slanting cut portion into the solution of 2000 ppm indole butyric acid, that is IBA, for 1 minute. This 2000 ppm solution is prepared by adding 2 grams of indole butyric acid in 1 liter of water. For planting of those cuttings, we can use pots, plastic bags. These bags are filled up with soil mixture. A proper soil mixture is needed. Soil mixture contains about 50% of alluvial soil, that is fertile alluvial soil, plus 40% of decomposed FYM, that is farm yard manure, plus 10% of sand. Plant the cuttings, leaving only 2 to 3 inches of the top of the cuttings exposed. Cuttings can also be planted directly in raised beds, spaced about 60 cm apart in a row. Irrigate the pots or beds immediately after planting with the help of water can. Cover the top of each cutting with small polythene bubble for early sprouting of the cuttings. The cuttings will be ready for transplanting in 50 to 60 days. The percent success of this method is about 80%. Now, let us have information about the air layering, that is another method of vegetative propagation. Air layering, also known as guti, means inducing roots on a stem while it is still attached to the mother plant. The success of air layers is more in the rainy season because of the free cell sap flow during this season. The selection of plant is very important while going for air layers. Select plants of higher yielding desired variety. Plants should be free from pests and diseases. Select pencil thickness twigs. This is very important point. Before going for actual operation, defoliate all the leaves 30 to 45 cm below from the tip of the selected branch. Remove 1 cm wide circular bark without disturbing the inner part of the wood. This is very important operation, that inner bark should not be disturbed. This ring should be taken below the bud. Apply 2000 ppm indole butyric acid, that is IBA, on cut portion for early and profuse rooting. We have already seen that 2 grams of IBA in 1 liter is required to prepare 2000 ppm solution. Then cover the cut surface with a handful of wet sphagnum moss. The sphagnum moss is covered with polythene paper and tied with sutali. The sphagnum moss will keep the cut portion wetted continuously. Irrigate the plant at regular interval. From one branch, 3 to 5 or even more gutties can be prepared. Within 40 to 60 days, we can see the rooting in the upper portion of the cut. Initially, the roots are white in color. At maturity, the root color turns brown. Fully brown colored rooted gutties should be detached from the mother plant. Remove all the leaves from the layer to avoid transpiration. Remove polythene paper from gutty. Transfer these gutties in polythene bags containing potting mixture. Irrigate them as and when required. The planted gutties in poly bags will be ready for transplanting into the field after 2 to 3 months. Tissue culture is another method of propagation in pomegranate. Some private companies are preparing tissue culture plants of pomegranate. However, due to drawbacks like weak root system, terminal flowering, and high cost, it is not advisable. Now, if you summarize this topic of propagation of pomegranate, to get the high yields with better quality, the genuine planting material and proper propagation method is very much essential. Hope you understand this topic. Thank you.